Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another Launchbox News video. Today, I wanted to show you some new features in the brand new release of Launchbox for Android 1.13. With all of our releases for Android or even Windows, we've got fixes, improvements, and new features. With Launchbox for Android 1.13, this is no different. I want to go over some of the main stuff that we've added here, the new features in this version for Android. And the first thing we're going to be talking about here are videos. And for the longest time with Launchbox for Android, we've been able to add our own videos per game. You could do it manually, or you could use EMU movies. But now with this new release, these videos can be streamed from YouTube, and we can also download those videos directly to our device. So it's pretty easy to get set up. What I want to show you here is just Dreamcast. We'll go in here. So with Sonic Adventure 2, I don't have a video going right now. I haven't downloaded one. I haven't manually added one. We do need to enable this new feature, and you can always turn it completely off if you want to. But in order to enable it, what we need to do is go to our menu, Options, and at the very bottom, we've actually got a new section here, Enable Video Streaming. We can also only play on Wi-Fi, so you don't use any of your data. Optimize Library. Basically, only really need to do this once after you get everything situated. And our video quality. I'm going to stick with 240p. Still looks good with a small footprint. Just going to keep that data and size down for us. But once we've got this enabled, what we can do is head back to our main Dreamcast. And now you can see it's playing a video. Now this video is actually being streamed from YouTube right now. But if we want to download this video, it's very easy to do so. Basically, edit metadata, heading on down a bit, you can see our YouTube URL. You can manually add one to any of these games if you want to, but I'm going to leave it right there, automatically chose that one for me. We'll back up. Now, I actually want to download this to my device. We're going to go to Edit Media. At the very bottom, Video, you can see it says None. Soon as I tap on this, we can download that streaming video. So I'm going to do that now. And you can see it now exists. So we've got that video downloaded from YouTube, and every time we go back, it's going to play that video locally for us. So this is really great for getting all of those videos up and running. You can leave them streaming if you don't want to take up any storage on your device, or you can always go ahead and download them. Very easy to do. Once we've got a video, edit media, video, download streaming video. And that's it. So we've now got these videos downloaded for us. Really awesome new feature for Launchbox on Android, and it's going to make life a lot easier for everybody to get all of their videos. Again, you can manually add your own URL, so if you want a custom video there, it's not a problem to do so. You can stream it directly to the device, and then when you're ready, you can always download it internally. Another new feature we've added here with Launchbox for Android 1.13 are navigation sounds. And these are actually customizable. You can download packs. I'm using the Sci-Fi Set 3 sound pack by Clavis. But with this new update, we've got several to choose from. Plus, we can add our own. Some people might want this disabled, but I'll show you how to use it. Really simple. From our menu, we're going to head to Options. Just scroll down a bit. We're going to see Play Navigation Sounds. You can enable it or disable it. Play navigation sounds with directional inputs held. So if you're scrolling for a while, just holding down your D-pad or whatever you're using as your directional input, you can have this disabled or you can have it go through really quickly if you want to. And of course, we've got the sound packs here. I'm going to swap out from classic to the multi-sound default. So this is going to be default for Launchbox on Android. We're going to head back to our main menu. And now we've got that random sound each time. And there's a ton in here. Personally, I like using the random sound pack just because we get that different sound each time we scroll. I think it adds a little more to the whole user experience. And adding your own sound packs is really easy. What we need to do is find some sound packs. We can head over to the Launchbox forum. Under the sound pack section, there's a ton to choose from. Go ahead, find one that you like. I went ahead and downloaded the Pandora's Box 4, 5, and 6 UI sounds by KimSama98. In my download section, I've got the folder, Pandora's Box, with the sounds in it. We're going to go ahead and just copy this whole folder. We're going to move back, find our LaunchBox directory in here, sounds, and you'll see we've got the classic multi-sound sci-fi, all of the ones that came pre-installed. We'll paste the new sound pack in, move back into LaunchBox, options, sound pack, Pandora's box. We've got that new sound pack enabled. We've also revamped the search function in LaunchBox for Android. Now it's going to prioritize the title and alternative title. So for instance, we'll head over to All Games. I'm just going to search for Lolo. Obviously, we've got that search covered, but if you're looking to get more in-depth with the search, the advanced search function that we recently added to LaunchBox for Windows is also now implemented in LaunchBox for Android. I want to search for some Ninja Turtle games, so I'm just going to go with Turtles, Genre, Platform. It's going to bring them up for me. So we've got that really deep advanced search that we can now use with LaunchBox for Android as well as LaunchBox for Windows. And finally, we've also added the ability to set a global view for all sections. We can use the root filter, secondary filter, or game views. And this is going to be accessed through our Manage Themes section. So we'll go to Manage Themes. Up in the top right-hand corner, little hamburger menu, Change View Globally. So we can set this root filter view. That way, we can set a custom view globally for each section. I'm going to choose Game View, and I'm going to go with Unified Light Vertical Wheel. So we'll enable this, and now heading into each one of my Game View sections, I'm using the Unified Light Vertical Wheel. And keep in mind, with this new feature, it's non-destructive, so if you've spent time setting up each different section to your liking, just going back into the Manage Theme section, you can choose none instead of a global variable, and it'll go right back to how you had it set up. This is just kind of an override. So yeah, we hope you enjoy this new version of LaunchBox for Android, and we've got a lot more coming, so definitely stay tuned to the channel and the forum for updates. But that's going to wrap it up for this one, and like always, thanks for watching.